Well, so this is the question number 86. It is a statement based question. A point particle of mass small m moving with speed v collides with stationary point particle of mass capital M. If the maximum energy lost possible is this, then F is equal to this. Statement 2 says maximum energy losses occurs when the particle get stuck together as a result of the collision. This is absolutely true. Hence, statement 2 is correct. As maximum energy loss when collision is completely inelastic. Talking about statement 1, the lost energy is equals to k initial minus k final, which is equals to half mu v square equals to half m capital M on m plus m square. Therefore, F is equals to capital N of m plus m, and answer three. Statement 1 is false and statement 2 is true. Statement 1 is false. This is the question number 87 of set Q. The amplitude of a damped oscillator decreases to 0.9 times its original magnitude in 5 seconds. In another 10 seconds, that is after 15 seconds, it will decrease to alpha times its original magnitude, where alpha equals. Damped oscillation amplitude decreases exponentially therefore A is equals to A naught into E minus KT 0.9 A naught equals to A naught at T is equals to 5 seconds, at T is equals to 15 seconds, alpha A naught is equals to A naught to 15, which is equals to A naught into e to the power minus A into 5 into E. So this comes out to be equal to 0.9 into A naught, which is equals to 0.72 naught. That is, answer is question number 88 of set Q. Diameter of a plano convex lens is 6 cm and thickness of the center is 3 mm. If the speed of light in material of lens is this much, the focal length of the lenses. First we have mu is equals to C by V, which is equals to 3 by 2. The arrangement is like this. This is given as 0.1 meter. This total is 6 centimeters. This comes out to be 3 centimeters. To find the radius of curvature r, we can use Pythagoras theorem, which says that r square barabar आर माइनस 0.3 होल स्क्वायर प्लस पी स्क्वायर विल फर्दर रिड्यूस टू 9 इक्वल्स टू 0.6 विल गिव अस आर इक्वल्स टू 15 सेंटीमीटर यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला दैट 1 बाय एफ इज इक्वल्स टू म्यू माइनस 1 इनटू 1 बाय आर 1 माइनस 1 बाय आर 2 इक्वल्स टू 1 बाय 2 इनटू 1 बाय 15 इक्वल्स टू 1 बाय 30 एज इट्स अ प्लेनो कॉन्वेक्स लेंस वन पार्ट विल हैव अ रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर इज सो आंसर इज The magnetic field in a traveling automatic wave has a peak value of 20 nano tesla. The peak value of electric wave strength is. For this, we are simply going to use the formula C is equals to E naught by B naught gives us naught as B into 10 cube 8, which is nothing but 6 volt per meter, and the answer is 1. This is the last question of your QSET. Two short bar magnets of length 1 cm each have magnetic moments 1.2 ampere meter square and 1 ampere meter square respectively. They are placed on a horizontal table parallel to each other with their north poles pointing towards the south. They have a common magnetic equator and are separated by a distance of 20 cm. The value of the resultant horizontal magnetic induction at the midpoint O of the line joining their centers is close to. Here we have the magnets. They are not all this is. This point that is which is a distance of 10 cm. We have to find the magnetic field. This point is at the equatorial position for both the magnets. So we are going to use the formula B equatorial is equals to mu naught M by 4 pi r cube. Direction of this magnetic field will be like this. The direction of magnetic field from this magnet will also be like this. And the direction of horizontal magnetic field, that is due to Earth, will also be like this. Hence the total field will be equal to U2 bar magnet 1 plus U2 bar magnet 2 plus horizontal component of our magnetic field. This total comes out to be equals to 2.56 in 10 raised to power minus 4. That is, the answer is 1.